fields the football at the 3. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. The Giants have played some amazing opportunistic defense so far in this game. They've been physically dominant, looking virtually impenetrable, and still pitching a shutout.
You said it. They have been awesome on the defensive side, dominating physically, just doing everything they want and hustling to the football. When you do all these things, that's why you've given up no points.
Final 30 seconds of the first half, and it's second down. Charles lined up in the backfield. The Eagles take it from the 28. And he heads to the sidelines out of bounds.
Good job that time by the ball carrier, picking up what he can, and he is very smart. Gets out of bounds to stop the clock.
This is third down. Taylor's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. Looking across the middle. It's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Giants use another timeout here, and they have one left. The defense needed to slow this game down, so that may be a very useful timeout. Now they're ready to go. Two tight ends on the field here. Finds Tate. Amukamara's there that time for the tackle. The Eagles will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. Taylor's setting up now in the pistol. First down at the 49. Scanning the field. And that'll close the gap. That touchdown should restore quite a bit of their confidence. They're not too far off the lead now.
Well, they're a confident team usually, but the way they were playing today, you could tell they were down in the dumps, not showing much emotion, but that has changed around. They are excited and ready to play.
Beckham's got it. And now he'll dip out of bounds. And a run back of about 17. Beckham's been tearing this secondary to pieces so far. And he's headed back out there to see if he can do a little bit more of the same.
Listen, he's one of the best in the NFL. And he's having an incredible day out here so far, taking advantage of situations and showing everybody how talented he really is.
The Giants have to call one right here, and they do, and they are out of timeouts. The Giants take it from the 38. Surveys. Comes down with, no, the defender tips it out. A good first half of action here, and soon we'll be sending you to Orlando and to our host, Larry Ridley. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. He'll have a chance to take off. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The Giants' defense had a strong first-half performance, and here they are to begin the third quarter, once again trying to make the stop and turn things over to their offensive unit, Phil.
Anytime you have a strong first-half performance, what do you look for in the second half? You've got to be alert on the defensive side, look for something that's different, but more importantly, look for that trick play, maybe a flea flicker, a double move by a wide receiver. Don't get caught in a situation like this on the defensive side.
First down here after the run. The Giants defense now is going to go nickel. Taylor's standing back in the shotgun ready for the snap. And this goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle.
That's what you expect in the NFL nowadays from the players, especially these receivers. They're so aggressive, so athletic. They go all out for every catch. That time he just lets it all go. Not in able to make the catch, but I'll give him an A for effort.
Smith is tackled down. That's his first reception today.
The Eagles just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
They better hurry to get the snap.
Luke Stocker with the reception. Mukamara's there to take it down. First down here after the completion. And now here's Charles on the toss. Breaks the plane. Touchdown. They've tied it up just as we're on the brink of the fourth quarter. What a time to find the end zone.
Well, you know, I don't know what on the brink is or where that is. All I know is you're right. It's late in the third quarter, and that was a big score. Boy, the defense has got to be deflated by the effort they gave on that drive.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Charles is taking the handoff. Could have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned away. The Eagles setting up here for the kickoff. Parker's going to start his return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
Look at the defensive line. Everybody's spreading out. I think they're going to try to pressure the quarterback.
And it'll be second down and six after the running play on first down. The corners retreating. So here we go, partner. The fourth quarter about to get underway, and you feel like the next offense that scores is going to end up winning the game.
Oh, I think so. When you think about this, my gosh, it's been so difficult and so hard for the offenses to do anything. So if somebody can come up with a new...
O.C. Umanyura brings the quarterback down.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback, and the best person to do it is the defensive end. What a good job that time by him.
We're late in the game, and the offense is in no hurry. Third and long. Scans the field. And he's going to be sacked. So, just three plays and out for the offense.
You got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
The Giants will punt the football. Mariani with a chance to return this one. And that's a gain of 10. They needed the ball back, and they got it off the punt. And now they need points, and they do have timeouts to work with here in the final 2 minutes.
Yeah, having those timeouts is everything. What do we always say? Use those timeouts in the first half. In the second half, protect them like they're gold. Give this offense and the coach credit. They saved a couple, and that's going to help them in this drive.
And he'll step out of bounds. That's reception number two for him.
The defense is going to play conservative in situations like this. They have a lead here in the fourth quarter. They'll give up those short throws.
Taylor's completion percentage, 80% on the day.
The Eagles, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You've got you're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
The Eagles get a first down.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
Taylor's now completed four in a row. And on the mark with Golden Tate.
Going to take it home for the touchdown.
So they take the lead after that remarkable run after the catch. And now the only issue is, did they score too quickly?
Well, look, you can only do what you can do. The offense went out there, and they took advantage of the situation. What a play, getting all those extra yards after the catch. We'll see if the defense can hold up.
The Giants prepared to return the kickoff. Beckham's got it. It out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Giants offense comes out here, Phil, desperately looking to put a drive together that can give them a chance here late to win this game.
Always the tough thing to do in a situation like this for the offense is don't try to make the big play. Let it happen. Take a short gain if that's what the defense is giving you, especially on first down. Get this drive started by doing the right thing.
First down. Pressure on every snap now. First down at the 41. Has his target. Second down, late in the fourth quarter. Second down and 10. Larry Donnell has the catch. The Giants call a timeout, their first. The Giants come to the line, fourth quarter, with two timeouts remaining. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Eli Manning takes it from the gun. Ball is out. Recovery by the offense. That's a timeout call. Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way. No bump coverage here. Corners backing up. Almost intercepted. Big third down coming up here. It's an empty backfield for Manning this time. Third and 11. Stands in the pocket. Easy catch there. No one near him. And as he's taken down, that's going to seal it as they will not get another playoff in time. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. And this is dropped. It was a nail biter. It wasn't pretty, but it goes down as a victory.
It's even sweeter when you win a close game in the league because you know how hard it is. And to make that one play, that was the difference. Whew, a lot of joy in the locker room.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance saying so long. I know we'll do it again. I know we're gonna collide. I know we'll call it the end. It's always, always a lie. You wear your heart on your sleeve. I wear my blood on my tie. But it's only love underneath. Just the sky. Turn it up.